Hello my beauty family, welcome back to my channel. For those who's new, hi, my name is Victoria and I'm here to share with you my passion about makeup and skincare. So if you still haven't joined my family, please make sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you'll be notified about my future videos. Also follow me on Instagram and I have a TikTok account with the same username. So in today's video we're gonna check out new makeup that I purchased at Sephora, and we're gonna talk about new hair care products. Some of them, all of them, I've tried, but I want to share with you my experience. I want to talk about those products since you know guys that I love my hair and I'm trying to take care of this. I'm trying to find the right products and sharing my own experience with you. It's just the best opportunity for me to help you guys if you are in the same search, if you're looking for perfect products for your hair type.
I believe there's a lot to learn from the horrors you experience.
I'm here for you guys, so I'm excited, and without wasting any time, let's jump straight into checking out those products. So I have one thing to tell you guys. I got an allergy reaction. I'm assuming it was maybe dust, but my eyes are watering and I got an eyeshadow palette for today to try. So please excuse me because you can hear that my voice is a little bit different. It's gonna come back eventually, but for now this is what we need to work with. My allergies are just crazy. I don't know, it's getting really bad, but anyway, I'm excited and I will not let my allergy reaction to destroy all this video, so I want to start checking out those products. From this Clinique Even Better Makeup Broad Spectrum SPF 15 foundation that retails for $31, and I got a shade Custard, and I hope it's gonna work for us. I hope it's not gonna be too yellow. So at first I want to say a few words about this foundation, why I chose it, and what is it actually. So this is supposed to be the best option for dry combination or combination oily skin. It's supposed to have 24-hour flawless coverage. It's not as heavy as your regular foundation. It has 56 shades. Whoa!
Whoa.
56 freaking shades, that's a lot. So there's possibility if you like the formula, you will find your perfect shade. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to do this because I picked this online and this is my online order. So I just, you know, read the description and just was trying to get my perfect shade. So apparently it's supposed to help to brighten our skin tone, and after 12 weeks of wearing this foundation, it helps to reduce the dark spots from acne, age, sun damage, and that's something that's really unique about Clinique, I'd say, because their makeup mostly is allergy tested, dermatologist developed, it's 100% fragrance free. So I'm pretty excited, especially based on the fact that it has SPF 15, and you know guys that SPF helps protect against future discolorations from the sun. Also it's supposed to be sweat and humidity resistant, and it will not change the color on our face. Most of the foundations are oxidizing on me, okay? So I'm gonna show you two foundations actually that's sitting in front of me. One of them is Lancome, probably one of the most favorite foundations. Another one is Too Faced Born This Way. Both of these foundations have my shade, and I want to show you how they look, how different they look. Look at this, that's insane. And this is because Lancome is oxidizing on me like crazy, so at some point it's getting close to this shade. Isn't it insane?
That is kind of crazy, you know.
But it is what it is. Anyway, I still love Lancome so much and I highly recommend you guys to check this out. The biggest adventure for you will be to pick the shade, the right shade. But if you will find your perfect shade, then you will have beautiful coverage. Since I have my moisturizer on, I'm not gonna use any primer for today because that moisturizer that I used is actually working as a primer perfectly for me. So I'm gonna shake this foundation. I'm gonna use my beauty blender and let's try to build some coverage using this foundation. It's actually a pretty good match for me, wow. I know I look crazy right now, but what I just realized, can you imagine guys that this baby and this big bottle has the same amount of the product, but just when you look at those two packagings, you're like, Born This Way seems like huge, and this Clinique foundation is like tiny. It's like an optical illusion.
Thank you.
Okay guys, I kind of like how it looks on my skin. It has really lightweight coverage. You definitely need quite a bit of foundation to achieve this result, but shade wise, oh my guys, I literally picked the perfect shade for me and I'm very happy about that. So far so good. I love how I don't feel this foundation on me, which is like really good sign. I'm really curious, will it make my skin oily at the end of the day? Because with some formulas, even with my BB cream that I really like, I need to use specific primer to take care of the oiliness, because if I will use hydrating primer and BB cream on the top, oh guys, I'm gonna be oily even though I have really dry skin till the end of the day. Oof.
Little splash of olive oil.
But if I will use like a unseen sunscreen from Supergoop before my BB cream, it's really good. So there are specific combos in makeup that you need to use to prevent your makeup from getting greasy. And guys, you will never know what product will work with another one unless you will not try them, and wear test shows everything. So if you want me to film a video and tell you like perfect combos that work for dry skin, let me know and I will definitely do this for you guys. Because all of this makeup hauls, what they made me do is finding perfect combinations in makeup that work amazingly. So I will be really happy to share with you guys my knowledge. If you want video like that, if you want to know what products work together beautifully, let me know in the comments down below and I will definitely film a video like that for you. And the next product I got is a pomade from Benefit. It's a pretty new launch, I'd say, and I'm really excited to check this out. So this is Benefit Brow Pomade. I got a shade 3.5 neutral medium brown, and this product retails for $20. It's supposed to be creamy waterproof formula. It's gonna last for up to 36 hours. This product is an Allure Best of Beauty Award winner. And also I want to show you guys one thing that's really cute in this product. So this product has the built-in brush wiper, and I must tell you guys, sometimes it's so hard to play around with pomade because there are a lot of excess of pomade that, you know, you need to wipe off. So I got 3.5 because I use precisely my brow pencil in the same shade. So I thought it will work for me. Hopefully that's the truth. So I'm gonna grab angled brush and let's try to use this product for my eyebrows today. And let's hope it's gonna work out nicely because I'm going to go out today. So let's hope I will not destroy my makeup. That's a really great thing. Try on new makeup products before you're going out. That's a smart idea, I know. Now I'm gonna use my clear brow gel from Benefit to set my eyebrows. You know what guys, I kind of like our eyebrows today. It was probably even easier than using a powder. And I remember first time when I discovered pomade, I just couldn't stop using this. I was just using this and using and using and using. It was my like daily routine. And then I became big time like a brow powder / brow pencil type of person. I wanted like a softer look. So pomade was too much for me. But now, not gonna lie, really like it so far. And the next product I purchased, it's gonna be an eyeshadow palette, and I'm so excited about this palette. Even though it's a baby palette, I still love the formula. And guys, if you're watching my video, you definitely know how badly I love Natasha Denona, and I purchased a baby palette from her. This is a mini love palette that looks just stunning, and it retails for $25. This palette is free of parabens, it's cruelty free, and guys, let's be honest, purchasing this baby palette per $25, it's kind of insane. I would prefer purchasing the whole palette that retails like $65. You're getting bigger pans and you're getting big variety of colors, especially knowing that Natasha Denona's formula is a really good formula. You know, when I received this, I kind of regret it. But anyway, let's check this out. I'm gonna apply my Urban Decay eyeshadow primer. guys, take a look at this. Those shades, the name of those shades. You are my true love. And I really love those color stories. So let's start from this shade that's called R. This shade I'm gonna blend all over my eyelids. Ooh, it's already so stunning. Obviously good eyeshadow primer helps a lot. Next, I'm gonna use the same shade to define my lower lash line. Next, I'm gonna use the shade that's called Mai. I'm gonna use a smaller fluffy brush and I'm gonna blend this on our outer portion. Then I'm dragging this towards my inner portion, following the cut crease. Ooh, how stunning is that? Next, I'm gonna use the same shade to define my lower lash line. Next, I'm gonna get a clean fluffy brush and I'm gonna basically blend this area. I want it to be not as sharp, but still has that dimension, you know what I mean? Next, I'm gonna grab my concealer and I'm gonna clean under my eyebrow. Next, I'm gonna do a cut crease. And I want to apply this pressed glitter. Ooh, this is actually duochrome. Wow. I want to apply this to our inner portion. Ooh, that's stunning. Oh my, this shade is everything. And next I'm gonna press the shade that's called Love at the center. So in this case, it helps to blend with other shade because this duochrome is kind of like a pressed pigment. This one is more cream powdery formula. Let's blend a little bit this shade. Guys, take a look at those shades. They're just beautiful. So let's do the same with our left eye. This shade is just literally my love. I like it so much. It's so, so beautiful. So I haven't purchased Retro Belt from Natasha Denona. I don't know why, guys. It's a great question because I love her formula and that color story was literally me in a palette. That definitely was a big mistake from my side. Next, guys, I have a little bit of fallouts underneath my eyes and I'm gonna take care of them. Next, guys, I want to use the shade that's called True and I'm gonna highlight my inner corners. She's literally giving you everything you need to create a beautiful look. That's just insane, like everything. Next, I'm gonna use my Thrive Cosmetics mascara and I'm gonna apply a few coats of mascara and then we will apply some falsies. And next, guys, I purchased new lashes from Sephora Collection since I really enjoyed my previous pair of lashes. And this style called Irresistible. Look at these gorgeous lashes. They retail for $10. They are vegan, have natural volume, and kind of lengthens at outer corners. I'm truly excited about them. So let's apply those falsies. Normally I would add some black liner, but honestly, for some reason today I want to skip it. I just like how everything looks without liner because of the shape of the eye look I chose today. Ooh, those lashes feel really, really lightweight. I like how they feel on my eyes and I love the way they look. They're so cute, right? They feel so cute. So now let me finish my complexion. I will apply bronzer, blush, highlighter, and also I will add some lip color. And next, let's set our face. Okay, guys, so here's the final look we created using new makeup I purchased this time. Let's jump into the second part of this video that will be all about hair products, and I want to start from the product that actually made me super upset yesterday because I purchased this a while ago. Honestly, I haven't used this for some reason, but what's happened actually, this product exploded on my makeup and it was really upsetting, guys. You will see basically what's left out of the whole new bottle of hair oil. So this is Gizu honey infused hair oil that retails for $25, and this is what's left from my oil. As you can imagine, guys, that was a whole mess and I was really, really upset. I really wanted to film a video yesterday, but this whole situation just, you know, really upsetting. I'm just reapplying oil. It feels really good. It's a really nice product. It feels pretty lightweight. Let's say if you tried Moroccan oil and Olaplex oil, this one is in the middle. It also has really nice scent, so it's kind of It's kind of luxurious product for $25, and I don't know what's happening, guys. I think they didn't just close it tight enough, and that's why I got everything covered with oil. Real upsetting. I had to throw away a lot of products, but you know, there's nothing I could do. But it's supposed to help our hair to be shiny. It takes care of dryness. I really like how it feels on my hair, I'm not gonna lie. If you're purchasing this, make sure that it's staying, it's not laying anywhere. Also, it's I wouldn't travel with this, hands down, I wouldn't. Because in this case, you will be even more frustrated. I had a bunch of makeup and skincare in this shelf where I put this oil, because those are products that I was gonna try on, that I was gonna talk about with you guys, and I got really upset. I'm not gonna lie, I got really upset. So it's good for all hair textures. I honestly would be really interested to see how it's gonna work with a wavy hair, because my straight hair is really like, it's dry at the ends obviously because my hair is dyed, but it still feels really nice when I'm applying this oil. It's not as lightweight as Olaplex oil, but it's a good one and it smells really good. Also, they came out with a hair fragrance. It smells interesting. Honestly, it feels kind of almost like dry. When I sprayed it on my hair, it felt really, really dry, but it smells really good. Honestly, sometimes I have a mood for some type of scents like that, but hands down, guys, out of all hair perfume, I love that spray from Moroccan Oil because it's just the best. I'm about to purchase the whole bottle because I had a small one, and that one is just amazing. The way how it smells, and it makes my hair so soft, so shiny. It's a hair and body spray, so you can use it for your body, but I love to spray this on my hair and I just love it a lot. I'm not gonna say the same about Moroccan oil because it's too heavy for my hair, and I was talking about this in one of my previous videos. It was too heavy. I was getting this kind of greasy type of feeling and I don't like it, so I'm trying to avoid this. So this oil was kind of in the middle of Olaplex and Moroccan oil for me. Honestly, I wish this bottle wouldn't be so poorly designed, because I mean, come on, you don't want to deal with this, you don't want to ruin your stuff just because this oil is, you know, laying with another stuff of yours. Honestly, I've never had this problem before, but it's just really frustrating. So be careful if you're actually purchasing this oil. Be really, really careful with, you know, how you're taking care of this. And just look what I got for $25. Yay! I'm really frustrated, I'm trying not to think about this. Just so you know, guys, this bottle leaks, so be careful. But it's a pretty good product, I'm not gonna lie, my hair likes it. I'm gonna use it, what's left at least. Will I repurchase it? I highly doubt. I probably will choose Olaplex over this one, but still, that was a really great experience, and I hope you guys get some lesson from my experience, from my mistakes. And if you are planning actually purchasing this, give it a shot, but make sure your bottle is standing, not laying. And the next product I want to talk about is actually a shampoo. This is hydrating shampoo from Moroccan Oil that retails for $24. And honestly, guys, what actually sold me is that this shampoo is supposed to be color safe. It's sulfate and paraben free. It has an amazing scent of Moroccan oil. Their signature scent, I really, really like it. And honestly, guys, after washing my hair with this shampoo, I kind of still smell it and I like it. It's not overpowering, it just, you know, it's nice. It's a nice scent to have on your hair. And I picked hydrating shampoo just because my hair is dyed and I want some hydration for my hair. I'm trying to be as gentle as possible just because I feel like my hair can look really, really shiny and beautiful even though it's dyed. But I just need the right products, you know what I mean? So this one is also good for all hair textures. I'm excited about this. I used this yesterday and I really liked it. My hair felt really nice. It's really, really foaming. It smells good. It's a really, really rich liquid formula. Also, it contains argan oil, algae and vitamin E that's supposed to help to retain moisture and prevent hair damaging and hair aging. I kind of really enjoyed this formula. I'm gonna keep using this. I will update you guys about this. There is definitely one more shampoo I want to try. I really want to try. And that one is in my Christmas list because I want to purchase big bottle. That was an advice from my hairdresser. She recommended me that product. And actually the next product I'm gonna talk about is kind of like from the same line because I want to purchase shampoo from Aveda. It's gonna be a color conserve shampoo. And my hairdresser gave me actually this baby conditioner from Aveda that's called Color Conserve Conditioner. And she gave me like a trial size. So this is a plant-based conditioner that helps keep colored hair look vibrant longer. I really really liked it. My hair feels so smooth and nice when I'm applying this after my shampoo, and specifically I applied this after my Moroccan oil shampoo. My hair felt like silk, and I'm not joking right now, it just felt so good. Every time when I'm using this, it just feels amazing, and I can't wait to try shampoo. It's pretty pricey, and as you know guys, right now a lot of sites, a lot of companies have their sales going on, so it's like the best time of purchasing this or another product you want to purchase. It's really lightweight, it smells wonderful, it's just so so good. I can't get enough of this, and probably I'm gonna repurchase this in a full size. I have like a two babies. She gave me two of these bottles, so I still have some of this left. But it just, when you have color treated hair, this is such a good product that will keep your color vibrant and beautiful longer. And it just so good. I really like it. And I remember talking with you guys about one, I believe it was some kind of a spray from Aveda that I was gonna repurchase, but then I got distracted by another sprays. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, it's so hard in this world to find something and be loyal to this, you know, because there are so many products I wanna try, and I want to talk with you about those products, and that's like my motivation for trying new products. So maybe I will settle down a little bit with my shampoo and conditioner from Aveda, but who knows? Who knows guys? And since this oil will not last me for much longer, I probably will keep searching, keep looking for my perfect oil. So far my Olaplex oil is the winner, but we will see. We'll see. Okay guys, that's pretty much it for today. I had so much fun filming this video. Hopefully guys, you enjoyed this video as well. Hopefully you took for yourself some inspiration and some useful information based on my own experience. Definitely give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also, don't forget to leave your comments down below because I really need you to help me in this YouTube algorithm. If you will leave your comment, if you will like my video, there is possibility it will be shown for more and more people. I'm so grateful for every one of you guys, and I always have so much fun sitting in front of you and filming my videos and talking with you about the products I love and the products I feel like you should skip. Okay, thank you for staying with me today. I will see you guys in my next video. Love you all very much. Bye.